What's the secret to my longevity in journalism? Three words: hyperbaric, sleeping, chamber. Works wonders. I'm actually 72 years old. Since becoming president in early 2017, Donald Trump has had three chiefs of staff, four defense secretaries, two secretaries of state, and six, yes, six communications directors. But in all that time, he's only had one Kellyanne Conway. Conway, the White House senior counselor, has been with Trump since his first day in office. And in fact, she's been with the billionaire businessman dating all the way back to his 2016 race, which she wound up managing in its final few months. So, what's the secret to Conway's success in Trump's Washington? I'll tell you. She's always understood that she's playing to an audience of just one. That one is Donald Trump. Know that phrase, if mama ain't happy, ain't nobody happy, right? Well, you know it now. That's pretty much how this White House works. If you aren't making the president happy on a daily basis, you just aren't going to be around for all that long. Now, Conway seemed to understand that reality from the moment she was named Trump's campaign manager in August 2016. She replaced a guy named Paul Manafort in that job, who you may have heard of. He's currently a resident of a New York jail. Now, Conway leaned into the whole let Trump be Trump school of thought and, against all odds, literally, found herself overseeing the single biggest upset in modern presidential political history in November 2016. Now, to no one's surprise, Trump quickly named Conway to a senior role in his administration. Now, within days of that appointment, Conway was showing her flair for just the sort of theatrics the reality TV president loved. She wore a $3,600 red, white, and blue Gucci coat, topped off with a jaunty red hat to his inauguration, and dubbed the outfit, quote, Trump revolutionary wear, end quote. Days after Trump officially became the nation's 45th president, Conway was making headlines and her boss proud with what has now become a defining moment of this Trump administration. Asked by NBC's Chuck Todd about then press secretary Sean Spicer's false claims that, quote, this was the largest audience to ever witness an inauguration, period, end quote, Conway responded this way.
You're saying it's a falsehood, and they're giving Sean Spicer, our press secretary, gave alternative facts to that. But the point remains.
Wait a minute. Alternative facts? Conway's alternative facts claim made her the object of condemnation and derision in and out of political Washington. But remember that whole audience of one thing I was talking about? Guess who loved every bit of Conway's confrontational and fact-free approach? Donald John Trump. What a job she's done. What a job she's done. Trump said of Conway in May 2018, she'll do the shows that nobody else dares go near. I'll say, do this one or that one. No problem, sir. Others say, sir, do you think I could take a pass, please? I beg you, please. Great going, Kellyanne. Thank you, Trump added. Conway's willingness to do those jobs no one else dares go near has insulated her from Trump's anger amid a series of self-created controversies over her first few years in his White House. Let's go through a few. In February 2017, Conway stirred up ethics experts when, in an interview with Fox and Friends from the White House press room, Conway said this of Ivanka Trump's clothing line.
It's a wonderful line. I own some of it. I'm gonna give a free commercial here. Go buy it today, everybody. You can find it online.
In June 2019, the Office of Special Counsel, no, it's not that Special Counsel's office, it's a different one, recommended that Conway be removed from her job due to her repeated violations of the Hatch Act, which makes clear that a federal office holder can't involve him or herself in overt displays of partisan politics. Conway laughed it all off. Blah, 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 she told reporters. If you're trying to silence me through the Hatch Act, it's not going to work. Let me know when the jail sentence starts, end quote. And guess who rode to her rescue on it? Yep. Quote, I think she's a tremendous person, tremendous spokesperson, Trump said of Conway in the wake of the Office of Special Counsel's recommendation. They have tried to take away her speech, and I think you're entitled to free speech in the country, end quote. And then there is the sticky issue of Conway's husband, George, who has gone from a potential appointee in the Trump administration to one of the fiercest and most outspoken critics of Trump from the right. When George Conway suggested in the spring of this year that Trump had an undiagnosed mental illness, Trump, of course, hit back on Twitter saying this, George Conway, often referred to as Mr. Kellyanne Conway by those who know him, is very jealous of his wife's success and angry that I, with her help, didn't give him the job he so desperately wanted. I barely know him, but just take a look. A stone-cold loser and husband from hell. End quote. Kellyanne took her boss's side in that particular fight. You think he shouldn't respond when somebody, a non-medical professional, accuses him of having a mental disorder, she asked reporters? You think he should just take that sitting down? Now, the latest Conway controversy came in mid-July when, in defending Trump against the firestorm he set off by his tweets urging four Democratic congresswomen to go back where they came from, sidebar, those four congresswomen are all American citizens and women of color, Conway asked a reporter what his ethnicity was.
Following up on the previous question, if the president was not telling these four congresswomen to return to their supposed countries of origin, to which countries was he referring?
He didn't say
what's your ethnicity?
He said go home.
Why is that relevant?
No, no, because I'm asking a question. My ancestors are from Ireland and Italy.
My ethnicity is not relevant to the question I'm asking. No.
That comment created its own firestorm, leading many in Washington to, stop me if you've heard this before, condemn Conway's line of questioning. Know who loved it? The only vote that matters in the life of Kellyanne Conway, Donald Trump. And that is The Point. We make New Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Check them all out.